Beautiful time of day again, and it's perfect weather. Eating some kelp. I think we need to head off home now, back to the tent. Just going to have a go going through the tunnel.
Oh, thank you. It's a bit bumpy, we're probably lurch against the edge. What have we got, about 6 inches each side?
Yeah, I'm not. Can't open the doors to get out.
No, it's stuck if we get stuck. It's going to be a long shoot. You want me to pause for a bit?
Yeah, pause. Okay.
Yeah. It's better. Know that the book says you can do it. Whoa, when you get too close over on your side.
Drift on now.
Yeah. Here we are. Well, that was exciting. This is apparently the mine site, so we'll go and read the plaque.
Squeeze. Going through there. Fireworks and seeing. Well, that's the same spot next morning. It's a blue sky, strong winds to the northeast around the wine glass bay, but clear for another couple of days, so we'll go and spend a couple of hours in the museum. This is the assay room. Assay furnaces. Well, it's only a model.
that towed 35 adults. You're Mr. Incredible, eh? Display of the West Coast. Thank you. blockade gets a mention. One mention.
There's a couple of the old poppet heads around the town.
That's the back of the museum, the courthouse and police room. And then here's the Gaiety Theatre. And this is where Dame Melba sang once. And the Sing Australia Choir sang here a few weeks ago. Here's a blacksmith's forge, and here's the wheels for frames for making wheels like Nana's grandfather used to do. And there's a the spot where you mount the tread onto the wheel. A few tools left over. That's the bellows that you pump up and down, make the air go through. The museum of everything. Everything mining and industrial. A spot just like this, in this museum, is where the ABT train came from for Strawn. There's a crusher, hammers. I can smell it here in pine.
Yeah.
Well, I think that might have to do us for this beautiful little museum, which we can recommend to everybody. Then we went underground and they've got the little museum underneath. With a very fine collection. This is all better than the AGSO BMR collection in Canberra. Oh, a huge array of minerals.
Yeah.
Serpentine, stitchite from the forces of the earth. And that's how they dig it all up. Put in their little wagons.
This is all very good.
muddy road. They still can't keep some of them on the roads. This is Granville Harbour. Very nice little spot. Well, there's about 100 houses, shacks, all the big places.
Yeah. Let's see where those people are. The boat just went.
There's
in there.
The boat ramp.
There's the boat ramp.
Over there.
Looks like a nice little harbour. A genial harbour.
They've got their own water supplies. They've got two or three creeks coming in. Dozens of trail bikes and quad bikes all over the place. And here's a reef dam named after some damming premier of Tasmania. The road goes up there to Rosebery and Burnie, etc. Lot of water. And the pieman. Just press the button for the barge man to come over. The ferryman. He started up his lawnmower engine.
It's a sign for when you approach.
I think we've been defeated. It's now 10:15 on the 7th of November, Monday, walking up the White River track beside the Pieman River. We've come to a barrier and it's certainly...
We can't see the river.
We can't see the river through the scrub.
It's a nice track.
And
apparently we've got Huon pine.
There could be some Huon pine around in the jungle. But we might go back. I think we've seen a few tracks now. There's the Arcadia, made of Huon pine, and ferrying people up the river. a few years. All the blokes gone fishing. It's after 10, so it's time for a stubby. I'm just looking for a walking track. Found it. This one here is about 200 years old, and that's what I split very easily last night. The firewood is a nice timber, but it burnt to nothing. Split very easily, but looked very hard. Well, the fishermen have all backed their trailers into the bush, taken their boats and gone fishing. And we're going to head off up the coast. Now we're heading off up the Western Explorer. Hasn't been much mobile phone anywhere except for Telstra. We're on the Tarkine Road now. 20 odd k north of Corinna, 120 odd to Stanley. Nice mountainous scenery, a couple of scenic lookouts, but no clear directions of where the scenic lookout is. We think this scenic lookout is just beside the road here, although the sign points us up into the bush behind us. There's your button grass amongst the flowers. A long back walk is up in there somewhere, but I think maybe it's a planned walk.
One of the sill sections going down.
positive side, which is different from what we've been through before.
Had lunch beside the river. Well, you know, our first crossing, first spot that we could have, a spot where we could pull off the road. And amongst all the regen, we actually got spots on each side of the road, a large bend in the river there. They spent a lot of money sealing sections of the road and some of these good bridges. All for nothing, I think. The road doesn't go anywhere. As someone said, the road to nowhere goes through a lot of ice country. But there's nothing out here. Here's your typical button grass swamp. Button grass plain. A bend in the Lindsay River. Big horseshoe bend. The 2.5 meter rainfall here blows in from behind me. Hits the sign, runs down the pole. Now roads the